you ask someone else?
No. I'll try to make it. I hope he goes Falcon. Wow, why not? It's super good against MK. He doesn't believe me. Yeah, Falcon's super good against MK. It's super good. C'est quoi, le neutral est con. Ouais, tu peux... Il peut te tuer, mais genre... Le neutral est vraiment bon pour Falcon. Tu peux vraiment bien bouger, puis genre... Tes hits, ils valent cher fort. La fois, c'est que les punish characters sont vraiment bons contre Metanite. Parce que s'il rate un mix-up, toi, tu le punish hard. Tu peux même jab, puis t'es pas, c'est vraiment bon. Je trouve ça vraiment bon. Voilà. Assaulting area with the fur lines. And for now, I'm playing Cloud against the MK, but I think as time goes on, I'm probably gonna switch the SS.
3, 2, 1, go!
It's better. Like for now, I go Cloud. Yeah, I feel it's. The thing is, like, when a character has good retreat touches, like, his back roll is super good, like, if he can jump and start with ZSS, I feel like if you play it in a way that you limit his resources, it's actually good. But okay, so it starts on the... Oh. Gets a back air. High dancing blade. Good. Oh, boy. Oh, okay. Natural, reach the air dodge, goes for the back air, is that gonna be enough? No. Forced to recover high, hold not covering it. Nice. Nice down tilt. I like the option, goes for the shield stop after the down tilt. Oh, he could have killed it, but no reaction. Ooh! Could have killed it there. Oh, nice! Reed gets the jump and gets the up air. No need to tipper that. That's what's fun about this, you know. You compare the marks, like, you get a Reed, and if it's the percentage right, it's dead. It's like there's no variance. It just happens. Gets a grab, goes for down throw. Okay, good stuff for Ho. Not her dodging, not getting, not letting Strawberry have 4%. Nice mix up, he's got a big punish. Goes for the other side, nice jump out! Stormer has to be careful because if he dancing blade downwards, it's, this is what he got. Goes for the back throw. Nice, he's stuck, snuffs out the jump, goes away. He could have killed him! S-Smash would have killed him, for sure. Down tilt. Oh, and gets the read. The down tilt to up smash. I lab this with the Strumbert session. I remember that. So, we were thinking of what we can do out of down tilt, and that's one of the things. Here we go for game 2, going on Smashville, super greedy coming out from Ho because this is... Oh, but the mix-up, I like that, he's gonna go straight and gets the kill, this is ridiculous! Oh, what? Zero for that, that was amazing setup! Okay. Nice. Back air cross-up. Just when Kaz arrives, you get to see one. Oh, he tried to get the shield break here. He wants some juice because he knows he's kind of in the deficit. Frame traps, good. Ooh! Oh, he tried to go for it all! He was looking for an air F smash there, I can tell you. I like the movement there, gotta be patient. Oh, this is bad. I think it's dead. Oh, we managed just to get out. Good stuff. The thing is, it's like, even if he kills the Metal Knight, after he gets like at the perfect percent, he'll catch back to open wards again. Oh, I like the jab. Did he get any follow-up? Oh, but the hit one is too much. Up throw is gonna kill. Is it? Oh, I thought it would. Nice. And that's gonna be enough. No DI coming up from Poe. And that's it. That's what I said. It's like, even if he kills him, it just puts him in the perfect percent where dash attack to Abby just works. It's like when you play against Bowser, you're like, oh yes, I'm out of the percent because he has rage now. And then you kill him, and you're back in the percent, you're like, ah, all this work for nothing. I like this game design. It's like you're in disadvantage, and then you manage to get out of disadvantage, but because you played well, you put yourself back at disadvantage. Like, ah, you're great. That's good stuff. Did you put the score for home? Did you put the 1 point for home? Yeah, okay. It's because of my beauty eye. Alright, so a couple short ups. Takes his time, sneaks a dash grab, that's good. Oh, the up is gonna get punished, but not too hard. Stuck to the ledge. Stronger, kinda misses the ledge trap. Oh, gets a couple trades in his favor. Dash attack, up air, up air, up air. Oh, nice. Good stuff, gets out. This is gonna be punished. Ooh, but the DI! Okay, he wasn't dead. Okay, okay. Tries to shield bait him. He knows the grab won't kill, so starts and shield. Goes to the ledge. Gets the, I like how Ho was playing there. That was super, super patient. Oh, okay. Chomper playing smart, staying close to the ledge, evading the post mix-ups. Forcing Ho to push. Because the dancing rate is gonna be a lot of percent. 22%. That's a dash grab. Oh, he tried to sneak something. Nice air dodge, going to the ledge. F-tilt's gonna be punished. Nice. Oh! Yeah, it's so good. Wow, that was a really good there. Okay. Nice and single, gonna wreck a little bit of percent. Crosses him up. Goes for the back throw, puts him on the ledge, that's what he wants. He's trying to play in a way that Ho is forced to the ledge. If he doesn't go to the ledge, he has to commit to a landing. Alright, alright. Nice grab. Dash attack. Oh, this is bad. This is super bad. Oh, I think he's dead. Yeah, that's it. Even though, like, that's the thing. Like, even if you play super good, the rage is gonna be enough to kill you. You're just out of one exchange. If your guess is wrong, you're gone. Super gone. So Strongbird's gonna try. Did you put the phone for Strongbird for Ho again? Yep. Going back on that, Strongbird feels it's a good match. I was trying to answer dodge, but it's gonna put him into a grab, so. Trade favorable for Sunbird. Try to get the tech chase, but just a little bit too far. Gotta get the grab, down throw, up air, super, it's 30% no rage. Double down tilt, it's gonna be him on the ledge, it's spooky. Sunbird gets grabbed, it's gonna be really, really spooky. Unlight it? Well, I'm not sure why. Hey, it's the other way around. Oh, one grab. Yeah. I probably didn't say. Yeah, I think I said that. Alright. Gets a grab. Good. Down throw. Gotta go for the upgrade. Nice. Ooh. Oh, he could've left him. Oh, he's dead. Oh, but now O is dead. Yeah, you can't make it back. I think he went for one too many up airs. Oh, that's it. Oh, but he misses the second hit. Plays passive. It's an Ecto there. Oh, nice Tomahawk. Super smart. Goes for the up smash. He's gonna try to follow him. Oh! He's gonna hit super hard, and that's where it gets spoopy. Because even if the person says 85, well, never mind, that's over. I never said anything. I was about to say that if Ho gets a dash attack, even if it's like 85%, it could beat that. But Nav Smash just eliminated any possibility. Okay, so goes for the back throw, goes for the up air. Okay, there's a dispute in the back about puppy slush. Oh boy, that was a... Well, Strombray is up one stat now. Strombray playing super passive, he knows he's not forced to approach. He's just gonna be content with spending those down tilts and forcing his own... force a mix-up, because he's like, yeah... I don't know. Nice punish, back 10%. Okay, trade, but it's not bad for Strombird, still in the corners. Gonna go for the Dancing Blade. Down throw. Oh! That would have been really cool. I like those resets, it looks fresh. Nice punish. Oh! No air dash coming out from Ho. Ooh, wow! That was super nice. Oh, he, okay. Beats him up. Oh, okay. Could have been in there for a second. Down throw. Special, okay. So it's looking pretty good for Stumble because it, it's very difficult now for Hulk to make it back. So now he has like a month as well to work on. He has to get like that juice. That juice. Is it enough? No DI again. So Strawberry takes the weekly out. Good job. Bravo. So managed to beat his bracket demon. He got like the he sacrificed a unit in Fire Emblem Heroes and he got the Meta Knight Breaker. Now he wins the Meta Knight matchup. He still takes damage, but he can still beat them. Yeah, yeah. Like, it's like a Berserk thing. Like, you deal more damage, but you deal more damage, but you can't hit yourself. Exactly. So, yeah, that's that. I don't think that, okay, there's Please Invade this Saturday. Yeah, you have to at least watch it. Yeah, that's gonna be our super guy Jay coming out from Montreal. I'm just making this up. It's just Jay with multiple Ys, but he is coming. There's a couple other people coming. I suppose that Jay is not coming alone because that would make him super lonely. He's coming with probably a super Mamadel. They're all super in that family. Madero's super Madero's bros. Anyway, we're gonna close the stream and see you guys Saturday. Or if you're not able to come, if you're not able to watch the stream, come back on Wednesday. We have those weeklies every week, Quebec City, Laval University, and we see you guys next time.